In today's video, I'll be going over how to use every chart in Excel, hopefully give you some different ideas on the visualizations available in Excel, and also give you some new ideas to tell a story with your data. To get into the video, I did upload this to my website. The link is in the description if you'd want to download the file. It'll be under video files. If you click here to download, and when you open the file, it will have a description of what every chart is used for, as well as the same sample data and sample charts that I used in this video. And if you enjoy the video, remember to subscribe and hit that like button, as it'll help my channel out a bunch. And let's get right into using every chart in Excel. The first chart we'll be covering is the column chart. So we have to grab some data, and with all the charts, we'll go to Insert, this little charts tab on the ribbon, click down in the bottom right, go to All Charts, and click on the basic column chart. This is great for categories such as A, B, C, and so on, or also different names, not as much year over year, as a line chart's normally better for showing year over year. Bar charts or column charts are great at showing one category to the other. And as you can see, all these different categories, and if you hover over them, will give you the sales values and the series. And along with the columns, there's also stacked columns, as with most of these charts. So this will be the one directly to the right. If we choose that, this will show the previous, which will be sales A, and then stacked on top of that will be sales B, just to show multiple data points. And if you hover over them as well, it will also give you the values. The next chart I'm going to cover will be the line chart. This is great for year-over-year data, such as having sales data from year to year. Once again, go to Insert, Charts, go to the line chart, and this will show a data point from 1 year to the next. And it's great at showing either an increase or a decrease in a certain category or data point. And same with the bar chart, there's also a stacked line. So if we insert a stacked line chart, so this will be another way to convey data between years and different data points and show increase and decrease of those specific values. The next chart I'm going to cover will be the pie chart, and very similar to the column chart, is great at showing categories and also one other data point. This could be sales or percent or any other just singular data point. So if we click Insert, go to Charts, All Charts, go to Pie, we can insert this. And from here, as with all charts, we can click on this little plus, and this will give you different elements. But for pie chart specifically, data labels are very useful. And also, if we click on the actual data labels and go to Home, we can change the background, which will make it easier to read the data and just see the different values. And another way to use the pie chart will be to either expand it or contract it, which is also known as a pie of pie. So if we go to the charts and go to a pie of pie chart, this will be a way to show a smaller piece of the pie expanded. We can also create a background for these. And if we click somewhere in the pie and right click and then click Format Data Series, we can go to the split series by. We can go by value, say everything less than 1000 will be included. If we click anywhere else, it will include anything in this data series that's less than 1000 in this small piece of pie. As you can see, the $1,820 expanded will be these different categories or points of data. And so moving on, we'll go to the bar chart, which is essentially the same exact thing as the column chart. Instead of vertical, will be horizontal. So there's not much to say here other than it's a different way to show the data. And we can also do a stacked bar chart here. And will essentially be the same thing. You can hover over and see the different data points. And the next chart will be an area chart. This is very similar to a line chart, just as the bar is very similar to a column. And it can be useful for specific things, but a way to use the area will be showing data in a way where you see the 800 here for 2017 and then the 980 behind it. So it's a way to see the percentage of each dependent on your data, or you can also grab it and kind of have a stacked area chart, kind of like how we had a stacked line chart. So this is useful just dependent on what your data is and the way you want to show it, whether you want to show it as a percentage of a whole, or if you want to show them stacked together is also a nice way to look at it to see just visually what fills up the most area. So the next chart will be a scatter chart. So scatter charts or XY scatter charts are great at showing correlations. And always think of sports data whenever looking at these charts because they like to correlate certain things, but it's useful for many other scenarios. Here we have some NFL data from 2023-2024 season. So if you think of correlation, you can think of the more attempts by a quarterback, the more touchdowns they will have. And you can see if that's true by inserting an XY scatter chart, which we click here. There will be a way to see the touchdowns or the attempts from touchdowns. You can also add axis titles and just click on them to change them, such as with the title of the chart as well. And that goes for all of them. But if we add a trend line, you can see that there is an obvious correlation between the amount of attempts or amount of passes thrown and touchdowns, which I think is a very obvious correlation. The more you pass, the more touchdowns you're going to throw. And this proves it here. And this chart is great for statistical analysis and getting your data points across. And moving on, the next chart will be the map chart or a heat map. So before we get into creating a heat map, there will be something you need to do. So states work the best. Cities are a little too spread out and are smaller, as you'll see here shortly. So if we grab this column and go to data, the data type will want to be geography. It will automatically detect these as states. And so now if we grab this whole table, hit insert and charts and go to the map, you can see here it connects with Bing Maps to detect where these places are. And the darker the data point or state in this case is, the more sales there are, and the lighter the least amount of sales. And this chart is great at showing a very simple, easy to look at visual for a data point such as sales and where you're doing the best in either a country or a state. We will need a certain data type in Excel. So if we have this cell selected, we can go over to data and click stocks instead of geography. This will detect the stock. You will need to click the right one, but if you also have a large list, it normally detects. We will want Amazon.com listed on the NASDAQ. And now that we have this, we can put in a formula, which will be equal stock history. So the way this works, you'll want this stock, which is already detected by Excel and linked, and then put a comma for our formula. The start date, we can pick whatever date we want, another comma, and the end date. And the interval, we could say that we want to do daily, and then the headers, we can also do show header, and the properties, we will want the high, the low, and also the close price. And then we can close the parentheses. And so now that we have, let's fix this. This should be a currency, but we can do that here. That will change that data type. So they're all currencies. If we select this data and go to the charts, we can now insert a stock chart, which will tell us, if you hover over, the high, the close, and the low, and will track over time the movement in stock, whether it's the high, low, and the close price. And this is useful for tracking stock data over time. The next chart will be the surface chart, which is very useful not as much for financial reasons as it is for something like tracking elevation. For this example, we have a trail and the certain miles of a trail and the elevation that could be in feet. So if we grab all of this, now insert a surface chart. What this surface chart is doing is saying that in the first mile, the elevation will be 400, and then it will slowly go down to mile two. And you can see the different areas here are depicted in colors. And this is just a cool way to visualize something like elevation and trail mile and show kind of a high and low point. I do think it works better for a chart that does start at a high point and kind of comes down and goes back up, as opposed to something where you maybe just use a line graph if it went straight across or an area chart. The next chart will be a radar chart, where we're going to want something like month or over time and some other points such as sales for different categories. And month is just an easy one to use for this, where if we insert the chart, you can see that the different categories. So here is swimsuit. You can see swimsuit sales are more popular in July and June, and they're very low in like October to pretty much March, as well as Christmas decor spikes in November and December. And sometimes I like to get rid of this chart if you already know about what numbers you're working with, because it's not always in the best spot. In candy, you can see spikes in October, and it's a great visual for showing like where these points lie within this large circle of data. And it's pretty easy to kind of tell immediately where certain things happen. The next chart will be the tree map. So if we grab this data here, which we're going to want a category and then another type of category, but in this case we have company, and then we'll do sales for sedans and SUVs. So if we grab all of this, click insert, all charts, the tree map is great at showing the difference between sedans being blue, SUVs being orange, and vans, to see Mercedes sells the most vans, Chevy's SUV, sedans also Mercedes. But this works if you have this specific column sorted from A to Z or in some fashion. So if we unsort, and let's say that sort by this column, which we can do by going to sort and filter A to Z, you can see now it's like there's two sedans, two SUVs, or well, actually three sedans, and it's just not good to look at. Whereas if we grab this and sort this again, A to Z, it will sort them back. So you do need a sorted category for this. And this is great for just giving a quick overview as to what categories are doing the best, or companies for specific numbers that you're wanting to look at. Very similar to the tree map will be the sunburst, where we do need a sorted category or sorted column here, such as weeks, where we have ones, then twos, then threes, and then months that are kind of jumbled around in sales. So if we grab this and go to sunburst, and so it's broken out by the first week of the month, you can see the different sale points. Then the third of the month, you can see has half of all of the sales in the second. So this breaks down this first one on the inner circle, and then this individual part of this on the second circle. So it's a great way to kind of break it out and see, oh, we did the best in the third week, but we actually did best in April, as opposed to, you know, we did next best in the second week, but also the best in April, but this time in February. And it's a great visual for getting a little deeper than like a pie chart. And the next chart will be a histogram chart, where we will want a column that's sorted by category and in alphabetical, or however you want to sort it, in sales. We can insert that. And so a histogram will break out from sales from 250 to 1600. which will be a data point, and then from 1650 to 3050, and then 3050 to the highest, which will be 4450. And in this case, it'll break out the number of sales. So in this column, the number of sales between this point will be 10, and this one will be 5 for this range, and this one will be 2. And this is a great way to categorize your sales based on a certain threshold and the values, more of a count of each one instead of a sum or total. In the next chart will be a box and whisker. So for this, we have a car origin and also a mile per gallon. So if we grab this data, we can insert a box and whisker. So for this, we will want a certain category, such as car origin or any other category that shows up multiple times, and then some other data point, in this case, miles per gallon. And for the box and whisker, this will be the normal range between about 23, and at the bottom here will be 14, and anything outside that will be an outlier. So there is one car origin of Japan where the value is 30, which is an outlier. Same as with USA, there's an outlier of 35, and also 13. In Europe, outlier of 12 and 31. So this is great at just kind of categorizing the data and figuring out which ones are outliers in the data and where the averages sit. The next chart will be the waterfall chart, which is great whenever you have an increase and decrease. So for this example, we have some finance terms, accounting terms, we got some revenue, cost of goods sold, interest, taxes, appreciation, where revenue will either go up or down. And so if we grab this, essentially what a waterfall chart is doing is showing the increase and decrease. So you can see the increase here, where sales revenue goes up, cost of goods sold goes down, then interest goes up, taxes goes down. So it's a way to show an increase and decrease. And then at the end, you'll get your final total at around 6,000, but it's a great way to visualize the increase and decrease. And the next chart will be a funnel chart, which is essentially a different way of visualizing a column or bar chart. So the funnel will be depicted this way. So you can sort this column here by highest to lowest if you wanted it to be kind of like a pyramid chart or kind of show it, or you could do vice versa, largest to smallest, you wanted it the other way. And it's just kind of a different way if you want it to make a specific visual. And last but not least will be the combo chart, which is extremely useful. So if we go to insert a combo chart, this will show you can mess around with the different chart types, and essentially it will give you two different chart types, such as a column and a line in this case, where sales A is shown in blue, so this will be 1500, but if you go to the line, this will show the 1320. Just if you go here, the 630 and the 750, which would be those two, and is a great way to show two different points and also integrate two different charts. And that's all I have for you in today's video. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe and hit that like button. It helps out a lot. And thanks for watching.